Hey guys, what's going on? Sudgriff here, and this is episode 2 of 1.16 Survival. Last episode, we just kind of walked around a little bit, found us a nice little place to set up our base. And then we just got a full set of iron armor, just got everything ready for later on in the series. Now this episode, I'm not too sure what we're going to be doing. I think we're probably going to be heading down into the mines to obviously get diamonds and to get more geared. As I talked about some last episode, it's not going to be real smart for me to go into open caves. The best bet for me is going to be to strip mine. I got enough food. Okay, I'll be ready to go. Get a little bit more wood, then we'll be good to go. Yeah, the open cave part of it is going to scare me because there's so many mobs that spawn in open caves. So I'm going to have to be more cautious about my approach to caving by just really only strip mining. I know it's going to be hard for you to watch, and I'll probably fast forward or cut through the mining sessions and maybe make a small like little mining montage of it. I'm not too sure what I'm going to do yet with editing, but this is going to be something that's going to be kind of difficult and very time consuming. There might be some I do off camera, but I'm not too sure, and I kind of don't want to do things on camera, but I mean off camera, because it's a stereotypical YouTuber thing to do, is to do a lot of important things off camera that so people don't get bored of watching them doing long, strenuous activities like mining, for instance. I'm going to have to go put some useless stuff in the chest, make a chest and go put some stuff in there so we have a good, clean inventory for when we go mining. Oh, apples are nice. Oh, golden apples going to be a real good thing later on in the series. Especially for keeping me alive, for quick regen and 2 extra hearts. That's going to be real nice. Eventually, I would like to get to the point where I'm carrying around regen potions, stuff along those lines, so that I'm really protected at all times, splash potions of instant healing, stuff like that. So it's going to be... didn't even put the sugar cane in there. So I'm always prepared for really any scenario, including... why do I need doors? Including, you know, having to regen quickly, including have to get out of a situation very quickly. Just kind of staying out of danger. And that's going to be something that's not going to be very hard during the series. But when I get into it, I need to be able to get out of it really fast. Because my goal is to really defeat the Ender Dragon this first go around. Really, am I going to be able to do it? I'm not too sure. I've done it only like once in like a survival world. And that's about it. Well, in my own hardcore survival world. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to light this little area up here. I don't need to be doing that. And start my little mining session right here.
Let's have a bit of fun till I downfall. My love, if you feel like I do right now, don't say you're on the run to the other side. My love, you say you wanna try, but you never do. Sugar, there's a reason why we lose.
Alright guys, that sure was a good, nice mining expedition. I hope you enjoyed that little sped up area, the little, I guess it's called a little mining montage. Get up in the darkness, that's gonna be fun. Kamikaze by a spider, that's great. Okay, there's a creeper, skeletons and all kinds of stuff, and another witch. Which, well, I did run into one of those in a mine shaft. Can I please get in bed, thank you. Okay. So with all that, we did actually manage to find 13 diamonds, 14 gold, 50 to a stack of iron, not counting what I've used. And I didn't really focus on coal that much for some reason. And I've got a lot of redstone. The real good thing about having all these diamonds is eventually I'm going to need to go get enchantments. And that's kind of one thing I'm going to do here in just a minute. Is go get stuff for enchantments. Obsidian. Do I have leather? I do. I have one piece of leather. So that's one book. And that's all we need for an enchantment table. So let's get all this stuff smelting. Now, is that creeper still there? Okay, no, it's gone. Oh, that's terrifying. Look how many skeletons are in that water pool. That is absolutely terrifying. Okay. Okay. So what we're gonna do is get some water here. And head back down to the mine, make a diamond pickaxe, and get ready for very basic enchants. Or should we just go on, and what we should do, we should just go on and make a pretty good enchantment level, and go on from there. 1, 2, 3, leave the diamonds in the chest, make us a pick, got us a water bucket, and we're good to go back down in the mines. Alrighty, I'm back with that obsidian, I got 4. Obsidian enough, we need 4 enchantment table. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. 1. Turn that into paper. Book. Obsidian. Diamonds. And there we go, we got an enchant table. Alrighty, now that we got this enchant table here, what we're going to do is set this off to the side for now. Put it in our chest and come over here and start making our wall of fortitude. I say that kind of jokingly, but this wall, as I talked about last time, is going to be a very crucial thing to help keep our base a very safe place. Alrighty, I think that should be enough. So I guess we're going to start it. How much dirt do I have in my chest over there? That's granite. I have no dirt. Okay. I have 17. Okay. So I guess what we're going to do, start flattening this out some. and cover up that water source. I don't want that one there. The farms we're probably set up about right here. Then we're going to have our little mining area. It looks like it's getting dark. So what we're going to do is we're going to go get in bed real fast. All right. So we're just going to kind of start leveling this land out some. Turn that down a little bit. Blah. Just turn it down to about 13. No, that's not at all what I want to do. All right. So... with this, what we're going to do is going to keep us a lot safer. Is that zombie still alive? Ah, there he goes. Okay. So we're going to just clear this out and build a wall. This wall is going to keep a lot of mobs out. And it's going to be also keep us able to move freely throughout the nighttime. I know it's going to be hard for me to stay up only during the daytime. So what we're going to do is just go ahead and build this so we can be able to work and extend our farms, wheat farms. Eventually, I think we may have a potato or two in there. I don't know. But I know for a fact, go ahead and make us a bread farm. Then we can start bringing cows, chickens, pigs, and what have it over into the area. And we might bring a few llamas just for giggles. Let's go ahead and start about right here. Not go much further than this in the back. Because what I'm thinking about doing is eventually having a bridge where go over that way, connecting us to that big island, well, the other mountain biome, so we can kind of transport in between safely, because I do not like having that water there. I don't like it. Just for the pure fact, if I get stuck in there and there's a skeleton in there, I'll be absolutely screwed. And I don't want to be, and I don't want the reason of death being me being stuck in water and being shot to death. That's not what I want happening at all. I mean, I don't want that to be the death of us. So that'll be one awful way to die. Oh, Griff, how did you end your 5-year survival series? Well, I got shot in water. That's not how I wanted to explain. I'd rather be said I got, I don't know, gang raped by like 30 witches. No, I'd rather say something that's more logical and harder to survive than, oh, I just got stuck in water and got shot to death. I don't think that's going to be a real good thing. I keep misplacing blocks. Okay. Go ahead and take this little area out too as well. Alrighty. So we got a nice little flat area working out right here. I think what we need to do next is after we create the wall and make our farm, is maybe turn that, our current house, into our chanting area. And then maybe start having a bigger house project over there somewhere, I think. Kind of right here in this little dip in between. I think that would be a good place to have a house. Alrighty, so we got just a little bit of food. We ain't got much, but we have some. Alright, let's go ahead and start making this area here more farm-worthy. And get it ready to go. Yes, I'm blocking up all the water. We have a limited water source down there. And what we're going to do is probably put it somewhere right here. I don't know. If I want to fill this out, it's going to take a little bit of time to make everything flat and a lot of dirt. So just doing a little bit at a time is going to be great. Just kind of knocking it out and moving things as we need it. So, farm's going to be right over here. Now, this is just bugging me now. Just stay even with everything. That needs to go. That one particular block needs to go. Alright. So that looks a little bit better. So what we're going to go in and do is start making our water source somewhere right. Need a new shovel. Let's make our source somewhere right here, I think, is what we're going to do. New shovel. Where's my sticks? Sticks. Yeah, whatever. I'll make some more. Alright, sticks. Oh, come on. Just go ahead and combine these two, just because why not? And start digging out our little water pit here. Alright. Let's have it here. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Get more water. I don't know what's been up with this glitch recently, but when you pick up water source block, it may or may not just bubble up like that. Just take the source block and the rest of the water just kind of stays there. It's getting kind of annoying because whenever you're doing it in like a PvP scenario, you don't know if you have your water or not because there's still water flowing. And your bucket says you have water in it, but the rest of it is like, do I have 1, 2, 3... 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. Alrighty. Here we go. I guess a little 3x3 farm would be alright for now. It's gonna make, actually we have a crafting table on us. Let's make us a nice stone hoe. And get to hoeing. Not what I wanted. I wanted 3. Alrighty, so this farm, I think it's going to really consist of wheat for right now. It's going to take a minute before we can even get potatoes and carrots. Honestly, we'd probably have to find a village or get lucky with a zombie drop for a potato and or carrots. I don't know if zombie drops carrots. I don't really remember their items they drop by heart. But I know every now and then they'll drop a potato. And, so that'd be kind of nice. Did I really just use... I did, indeed. I know they drop potatoes. I'm not too sure about carrots. I think we do need to find a... Dadgummit, I don't have anything. There's a cow over there. That's nice. We'll go ahead and bring him over after we get everything walled up. Yeah, finding a village would be nice to get that. Those carrots. If you start making golden carrots, just a flex later on, that's probably, I believe that is the best saturation that we have right now in the game. It's either that or honey. I don't remember. Because I know honey right now is taking everything kind of by storm about how much, it fills up 3 hunger bars and it's got really good saturation. I don't know if it's as good as a golden carrot or not. Alrighty. So have ourselves a nice little farm ready. Get some water just in case. So now we can kind of build a wall around our farm and our house. Alrighty. Get this over there. Put that right there. Get up the hill. Alright. Nice luck. I guess we're going to start right here. What are you looking at? Okay, we forgot to dig this out. Come out one. You just kind of have it. No. So you just kind of have it just come out for now. Come around. Yeah, come on, come around this tree. Go ahead and chop this down. It's getting nighttime. I need to go to sleep. I think I'm going to try to finish the wall and light it up before I go to bed. Maybe work through the night. I don't know. But this wall's almost completed. Couldn't get this thing built up. All right, enough of the flowers already. Where is he at? Yeah, we're going to go to bed because this creeper and spider right there, and that's just exactly where we need to be. Hello, skeleton. Ah. I'm going to have to kill you, aren't I? Alright, let's try that now. Monsters. Zombie, die. One, two. Please, 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 please. Yes. Okay. While they're dying slowly, we will finish the wall. There's something below here. I don't know what it is. But I don't like it. Knew I saw a creeper. We're gonna need more walls too. Alright, so get some more cobble and I'll be right back. Alrighty, after a little bit of time of getting this wall finished off and the farm planted and a few nights of just trying to record and without the dogs barking, I finally managed to get to a point where I can finish off with this recording. So we've did a little bit. We've cleared off this land, got our garden going, and I did receive a carrot from a zombie. So we've got this ready to go. I need to actually get some torches while I finish out this episode. I don't have any wood now, do I? Yeah, I do. While I get this episode wrapping up. Okay. So while we wrap up this episode, I'd like to thank you all for watching. Sorry this episode was a little bit crazy. I'm going to do my best to have it edited correctly. It's going to be a bit difficult. Next episode is going to be setting up an efficient cow farm. Well, I say efficient, just setting up a basic cow farm for right now. And then maybe setting up a pig farm as well. And excuse me for trying to clear my throat. I'm still a little bit under the weather. And as soon as it'll stop raining here and everything, I should be fine. Just this weather's keeping me a bit clogged up in my head. No, I do not have coronavirus. Of course, I don't have arrows. But, that should keep you away. I'm just playing Runaway with this creeper. And I'll get to lighten up these walls here while we finish off. Then, okay, I think he despawned. But yeah, like I said, next episode we will have some cows brought in here. I believe I'm going to end up putting them in this corner here. There's some cows that spawn over there, so we'll be ready to go for that. I'm going to plant this carrot on the far side so we know which one's which. So thank you all for watching. Stick with me. This is a learning curve for me because there's a lot of things I need to learn how to do, like officially commentate and how to edit around my surroundings. It's a little bit difficult, but I'll be able to figure it out. Like I said, it'll be just a thing of time. Hopefully I'll improve enough where people and y'all can enjoy my video a little bit better. Or if not a lot better, it's just depending on your liking. But I'm trying. I thank you all for watching. And as I finish this off, I want you to comment down below what I should do next. Build a new house or start collecting things for an adventure. Maybe exploring that mountain biome over there, or maybe even trying to find a desert temple or an underwater temple. What is it called? Was it a guardian temple? And maybe some shipwrecks so we can get some free loot, maybe some gold, a good bit of diamonds, some emeralds, stuff like that. So thank you for watching this video. I know I said 1,000 times, but it means a lot for the people who watch. Tune in for the next episode of episode 3 of Survival. This has been episode 2. My name is Hoots Griff, and I'll see you next time.